and I'll be showing you how I use my RSI window to check for crash, to check for spike. So these are my settings. Moving up to 200 on the main chart, estimation chart. Then the second one, 60 period, relative interest 60 period 60 rather. Then these are my descriptions. Please add them, and then you go to another RSI window, see this close, and these are my descriptions too, and my levels. So now let's get to what we are trying to say. Now I use this RSI 60 to know if there is going to be a successive spike, like to know if there is still going to be a spike. Normally my RSI 60 is used to know overbought and oversold region. So now this is my overbought region, like overbought region here. So when it got here, I sold and it spiked B. Then after spiking, oh yeah, I forgot to tell you this here, the use of my EMA 200, this is just to know support and resistance. It serves as support, as resistance in a crash market. Can you see it? That it was rejected and yeah. So it's actually useful. So now, guys, sorry, this is okay. It came to overbought and it spiked down, but now it's going up already, and it didn't even get to another overbought before spiking. So our 80 line is our overbought region too, but it's not yet really overbought. So now then here comes the use of our RSI 60. Now see this situation, it's represented by the when it came down pa and touched our line 43. So now if I'm in this kind of market, I'll be expecting another spike before touching 47 or after touching 47 line, like this line. I hope you are seeing it, that line. So now let's see now it's the market moved up again. We are checking here. It first came down, but this area that I touched here and spiked. See here, it touched our 47 and spiked. Okay, now it spiked again, then came down again. I took another profit. Then it's already going up, and my RSI is still lagging behind. Like this RSI 6, it's still, and it came down to 20 and it went to 52 before spiking again. It's not even at overbought, it's just at the middle level. Then see this, I will come to my RSI 60. My RSI 60 is already going up and it has passed through my 47 again. I feel like, oh, this thing is going to spike again. And if it doesn't spike, it will spike on this 52 level. But then, luckily for me, it spiked P. Then I took another profit. Then, okay, this came, this spiked again. Then it went up again to that 60 level, to that 80 level. Then, within that period of time, my RSI 62 is already going up to levels of 52 level before then it spiked again. So this was not even at overbought region before spiking again, then trying to go up again and spike. Then you see this was just ranging around 43 to 52, and I've been using this thing to make a lot of money in catching spikes. I hope you understand what I'm trying to explain. You set these levels. Whenever the market touches any of these levels, you should be expecting a spike. Any of these levels, like any one of them. This. So in a normal trend, like in a normal trend of any market, the level should be between 30 to 62 or 70. Any levels above here, they are in an abnormal trend. So we shouldn't expect a lot of spikes around there. So we should only be expecting, okay, a big long spike and take profit and leave. We shouldn't be expecting successive spikes. Whenever our market is, let me say, 52 to 37, if our market is around that range, it means the market is really ranging, that we are going to be seeing a lot of spikes with ones. I hope you understand what I mean, like that. So now let us see now. It came here, it spiked. And this was already overbought, so it did confluence, like force F. The EMA touched the candlestick. This was already at 50 level. This overbought level, so we're expecting a spike. But when it spiked, it even spiked hard, but the RSI did not even go low, so it went only to the side. Sorry, so it went only to this side, it went only to here and came up again to this place. Nothing coming up there. Yeah, my EMA 60 is already at my 47, so I'm expecting another spike. So I took a sell, then it spiked again. Then I took my profit again. Then I'm expecting another retest on that 47 line. Then when it got there, it actually didn't spike immediately after getting there. So I actually waited, and probably I missed that one because it didn't spike on the 47. So I am expecting it to go to 50 to 52. So then, unlucky for me, it spiked more. Then I waited. Then after getting to 52 levels, then I took another sell and it spiked again. And after spiking again, I took my profit, and little by little it went up to 52 level again and it spiked again. So, and all these ones there, they are not even at overbought, they are not even at these levels within those period of time. So, but with the help of this, I've used it to take little profit and to scalp everything. So now, remember, this is our normal level. Our normal level ends on 70 to 30. Anything below there is, they are on abnormal levels. So we should be looking for spikes on that side. Okay. Yes. Can you see now? So now, assuming I'm in this kind of market, and this thing is already going up. This is going up. I will be expecting a spike around here. But luckily, unlucky for us, it didn't spike. So that's why this strategy is not 100%, it is just 90%. So with this, if you are able to catch 10 spikes daily with good loss size, it should be enough for you, and you won't lose a lot of money in this kind of stuff. Okay, it got here, didn't spike, got here in this spike. Then see, there is a rule for this spike too. Whenever our RSI 60 touches at least two levels and it didn't spike, we should be expecting a spike in the third level or fourth. So for this kind of point, we are going to be entering with a bigger lot size to catch the big spike. Then okay, it broke here, then later it spiked there, and after spiking it continued up. Then I know when it will never go above this side. If it goes above that side, it means the market is really going up. And don't forget, we should always catch spikes whenever crashes on the downtrend. I mean crash spikes on a downtrend and boom is on an uptrend. So now this two is applicable to boom 500. Can you use to catch spikes to boom 500? Can you see touching our pivot lines and spiking again? So thank you very much. Please subscribe to the channel, and if you have any problem with this strategy, feel free to contact me. I will explain to you more on how this works. See now, okay. Yeah, before I go, can you see this? It ranges within our levels, like these are our pivot levels. Like I call them pivot levels, they are very, very sweet. Can you see? So, for every touch on the levels, and if you are taking a buy on this boom, you will always be in profit. Any touch on the levels, you'll be in profit. So, thank you so much, guys. Please watch the video, share with your friends, and if you have any problem with it.